So this might be just one of those chapters. This might take us like, we might get this in 10 minutes. This might take like a week of fucking attempts to get. Oops. Do I ever miss being an average player? There's no way for me to say this without sounding cocky, so I am just gonna say it. I was never average at this game. Like, action games really are my shit. Like, they are my jam. And I also really like fighting games, and I'm pretty good at fighting games too. And this game is basically just a third-person action fighting game. So, there was a lot of carryover between, like, my experience with other games when I started playing this. You know what I mean? Like, I was never getting bodied on normal. Like, that wasn't happening. Like, this game was, like, NGO4, for example, was hard on very hard. Like, it wasn't hard on normal or hard. NGB was hard on very hard and Master Ninja. Normal and hard were, like, totally fine. So, yeah. Not trying to brag, I'm just being real. Like, and also, average now means, like, what would be an average Ninja Gaiden player now? Like, I'd honestly say average now is beating Master Ninja, to be perfectly real. There's so much help and info out there for Master Ninja. Like, it's still an impressive thing to beat Master Ninja, but it's not quite the same as when the game first came out and someone had beaten Master Ninja, like, entirely on their own. You're like, oh shit, okay. You know, respect. It's the thing with a game this old, you know? Okay, so at least we remembered Muramasa this time. Nice. Yeah, he did. He did tell me, yeah. I know. Yeah, because he's at the same... That's why I'm wondering. Like, he's at the same point here. So I'm wondering what he's going to do. Like, is he going to grind out a strategy? Or is he just going to... just roll the dice? Because I'm thinking of just rolling the dice, to be real. I did play Tekken Force. Yeah, I quite like Tekken Force. Tekken Force was fun. It wasn't amazing, but it was a fun mode, you know? Barely beating Master Ninja is average. Yeah, I don't know. Again, like, maybe I'm just overestimating it, but I feel like there's so much info out there now for this game. It's like, Master Ninja should be fairly manageable if you just, you know, pay attention to what you're doing. I always said I'm the worst person to ask those questions to, because it's, you know, it's like asking Usain, it's like running a 100-meter sprint and asking Usain Bolt if your time was good or not, you know? Because he's gonna, like, I did it in 15 seconds, you know? Which is, like, quite respectable. But to him, it's like, you know, it's alright. You know, that's a Tuesday morning for me after, you know, a heavy breakfast. You know what I mean? And shameless disclaimer, no, I'm not saying I'm Usain Bolt. You know what I mean? It's just an analogy, people. Chill. It's just a point. Okay, well, that went well. I'd say an average player is someone who doesn't know about all the techniques in the shuriken cancels. Yeah, you see, shuriken cancels are completely... like, here's the thing with shuriken cancels, right? Shuriken cancels in this game... I'm gonna, like, drop a bomb on all you lot here. They are a total fucking buzz in this game. In NG2, they're a lot more important. In this game, you do not need to shuriken cancel ever. Ever. And I mean ever. You never need to shuriken cancel in this game. Ever. I'm not saying it's not useful, but, like, it's not something that you should be, like, telling a new player, you know? Oh, shuriken cancel. What? What do you mean? Like, no. Like, learn the fundamentals first. It's, here's a good comparison for that. It's one of the biggest mistakes people can make when they try and pick up a fighting game. Is they try and learn all this, like, technical shit. You know, like, they pick a character, like, oh, what's his optimal B&B? Or what's his optimal damage in the corner? Or, like, it's like, don't worry about that. Like, get a combo that you can do 10 times out of 10 in every situation. So you want an anti-air that you can do 10 times out of 10. It doesn't matter if it deals 10% damage or 25% damage. What matters is, can you do it 100 times in a row? That's what's important. But people don't do that. And that's where you can get people that, like, in training mode, they're monsters. But when they fight a person, you know, in a tournament, they're like, oh shit, this guy just did, like, this, and I had no idea what to do. And it's like, well, if you'd have played the game, you would have. Same in this game. Don't practice shuriken cancels. Just play the game. Fight every fight. Try and make the time limits. Fight every fight again. Maybe try and fight every fight after that, like, without Nimpo, so you don't have that cushion of making a mistake. Like, then worry about, oh, I can do, like, XXYB forward Y, you know? What's girls matching your calm run vid to watch you? Does that count as cheating? Yes, honestly. Like, not watching his video is blasphemy. Because it's so good. Nice. Ooh, got a red. Nice. Yeah, it's like, you know, you can use it on Alma for more damage, but you don't need to. You know? Yeah, I know what you mean, Skate Life, but, like, it is a good example, because it is the kind of thing that somebody would, like, focus on as a newer player. And it's like, nah, don't worry about shuriken cancels, you know? Funny enough, I meant to mention it in his stream, but he wasn't streaming for long. Guilty was playing the Hurricane Packs the other day, and he was trying to intercept, and he was, like, having a really tough time intercepting. And I wanted to say, like, don't worry about intercepting. Like, that's trying to run before you can walk. What you want to do when you're learning intercept, you need to know every single attack in the game. You need to know its position, you need to know its startup, and you need to know, like, whether it's going to guard break, guard crush, its recovery. You need to know everything. And you need to be able to block every attack first. Then you can worry about intercept. Don't jump straight into Hurricane Pack trying to intercept everything. You're just going to get hit. Because you need to put in that time to know the game. So, alright, come on, chat. I am gonna do this, because as I said, like, this worked at least, like, 3 times, so... Although I really... Where that fucking helicopter is, like, I'm dead. Oh, okay. Fuck you. Alright. I'm killing these fish here. I'm not leaving the fish alive. Because if you stay here, that helicopter doesn't try and laser you. Fuck you. Come on. I wish you could, like, Tomb Raider, like, 180 spin in the water. That would be really cool. There we go. That's just 4 grand. Come on, you. Come face the music. What Ted's about as well. Off. Nice. Money. I didn't know any guillotine throws are soon it drops. I mean, yeah, there's a good example, right? The first thing you should learn in this game, one of the first things you should learn how to Izuna drop. Like, learn how to get that every time. Like, that's a good thing to learn. You know, don't worry about doing, like, you know, hold down Y, shuriken, hold down Y, shuriken, neutral jump, XXX is gonna drop. Just do forward Y, XXY. Good shit. Like, the fighting game analogy is, like, the parallels in fighting games in this game are uncanny, seriously. And you see that a lot in fighting games. You know, someone will pick a character that's, like, boring. And, you know, you look at the comments in any of the videos. This character, man, this guy's not good. He just plays boring character. He does the same move over and over again. It's like, maybe there's a reason why he's doing the same move over and over again. It's because his opponent, like, if the, this is, I said this to someone actually when I was, like, trying to teach him some Tekken. And we were playing MK. But we played MK first. And he just said, oh, you're doing the same move over and over again. Like, I was just doing, like, a B&B. And I said, instead of looking at it that way, look at it this way. Ask yourself, why is the same thing hitting you over and over again? Instead of, this guy is using the same combo over and over again. And, like, that really made the penny drop for him. He was like, oh, yeah. Like, you're doing the same thing over and over again because I keep doing the same thing that's letting you do that over and over again. He just wasn't blocking. He was very new. Like, and I was like, just block, dude. Like, just... there's a block button, like, just block, and that won't hit you. Trust me. Okay. We are locked and loaded on Nimpo. I will burn every single one of my Nimpos here. If I have to. Like, I don't care. Chapter 12 is full of cash. Nice. If only this was Sigma. Oh, come on. It's like, the ET does really good damage to him. Wait, I'll take that. You bitch. Ooh. Alright, I had a minor heart attack there. Oh, come on! Are you taking the piss here, man? You can charge there, but I'm just not risking it. He's not done it a single time. No banana. In my fucking exhaust. You lady of the night. This time limit is kind of ridiculous. Dude. That's four. Five. I do this all day. can dance all day. Hit him. Yes. Right in the fucking moneymaker. Yes. Chapter 11 down. Yeah. Fuck you. Yeah. Good shit. Good shit. Took a lot of Nimpo, but... Oh, yeah. That's me doing this, by the way. Oh, okay, let's go save. Let's go save. Alright. As I said, like, Doku is not free, but, like, I was not worried about Doku. Like, as long as you're patient on Doku, you are fine. You are absolutely fine. Just, again, you know, just, you gotta keep it together. Like, was that 6 ground pounds, by the way?